All right, what is up, everybody, and welcome back to the channel. So with Vanguard being out for about a day now, you guys are probably getting more comfortable with the game and starting to get into those camo challenges, trying to unlock these camos as fast as possible. So in today's video, I want to help you guys out if you're struggling a little bit and show you guys how you guys can unlock these camos a little faster, give you guys some tips and tricks and all that good stuff. So before we get into today's video, do me a really big favor, smack an early like on today's video and subscribe to the channel if you guys are brand new. Also, I just want to point out, if you still do not have Call of Duty Vanguard, we currently are giving away an Ultimate Edition over on my Twitter account. Link to that is down in the description. If you guys want to enter into that giveaway, make sure you guys just follow all the rules over on Twitter. And if you guys don't have a copy of the game, make sure you guys stay tuned. We'll be announcing those giveaways very, very soon. Anyway, let's get into these camo challenges now. I do want to point out a couple things before we just get into this. Some of these camo challenges, there's a lot this year. There's over 100 camos per weapon for multiplayer. So it's gonna be a grind this year if you guys are trying to unlock that atomic camo and just get gold camo for your favorite weapons in this game. So it's definitely gonna be a grind. There's some really, really annoying challenges that we're gonna get onto later on in the video as well that some of you guys really might just be annoyed about, even just me trying to come up with some tips for how to unlock them. I was like, this is gonna be a really, really struggle, a big struggle to try to unlock some of these camos this year. But a couple little pointers I do want to throw out there real quick. One cool thing this year is some operators, they show off like their favorite weapon in the main menu when you're equipping them. So actually, if you do use certain operators that use their favorite weapon, you actually will have a double XP equipped. So if you're trying to rank up some weapons, I believe there's like the Sten is one of the weapons that is currently like a favorite weapon from one of the operators. If you use the Sten with that certain operator, you will have double XP, so you'll be able to rank up a little faster while you're trying to do these challenges. And another little tip here also, some of these challenges can overlap as well. So example, like some long shots and attachments that we'll talk about later on, you can do those challenges at the same exact time to make it a little easier and a little faster as well. So anyway, let's move on to each category. There is 10 different categories that you're going to have to complete the challenges for each of these weapons. So the first one here is going to be called Pack Tactics here. It's 400 eliminations. I mean, if I need to give tips on how to get eliminations in Call of Duty, you probably shouldn't even be going for these camo challenges anyway. So it's pretty straightforward. 400 eliminations with each weapon, and then you will complete that challenge, I should say. So anyway, moving on to the second challenge here is going to be called Surgical. And for this, you need to complete headshots, which is going to be 100 headshots. And since this is one of the earlier ones that you're going to be unlocking, these headshots should happen pretty naturally while you're just ranking up the weapons. But if you are somehow struggling to getting headshots with each weapon, you definitely want to hop onto hardcore, I should say, and maybe like set on a head glitch and just kind of play it a little slower and just make sure you're aiming higher every single shot that you're taking. In hardcore, basically, it's a one-shot kill, so if you just tap them in the head, they're going to die immediately after that. So hardcore if you are struggling with headshots, but it should happen pretty naturally as you're ranking up your weapons. So we move on to the third challenge. That's gonna be called Predatory Ambition. For this, you need to get 50 multi-kills, and for this you want to play your objective-based game modes here. So you might want to play domination or hardpoint and just stick to those objectives as much as possible, because a lot of times the enemy teams, they're trying to hop on a flag and capture something right away. There should be two people on there most likely, and you can just quickly run over to that flag or run over to that hard point, kill both of them if you can, and you'll be able to get that kill that way. And if you are struggling still and you can't get those kills in those objective-based game modes, slow down your playstyle just a little bit. Look for choke points in the map that maybe like the middle of the map where a lot of action is going to take place there, and just have that pre-aimed and ready to go. As soon as an enemy peeks that, you will be able to get those kills pretty easily there. So multi-kills, they're not too difficult, but if you are struggling, definitely make sure you just stick to the outskirts and play objective-based game modes here. Moving on to the fourth challenge for the camos now. This is going to be called Reptilian. For this, you need to get 30 Bloodthirsties. Now, at first I was like, oh, that's not too bad, 30 Bloodthirsties. But then I look back and I'm like, actually, this is kind of extreme if you really think about it. I think in past Call of Duty games, it's been like 10 or maybe 15 Bloodthirsties that you would need to get. So to get 30 of these, even though they're not difficult to do, I mean, a Bloodthirsty shouldn't be too hard for people to get, but it's one of those ones that's just really annoying, and you're gonna get pissed off every time you die on a four, and you're like, man, I how many times have I died on a four kill streak? And this could have helped me unlock these challenges a lot quicker. But if you are struggling for those Bloodthirsties, what you want to do, stick to the outskirts of the map once again. And this one kind of sounds a little stupid, but you want to avoid looking at the streaks that you're on. So if you're in your mind, you know you're on a four kill streak and you need just one more kill, it might just get to your head a little bit, and you might play a little more scared or a little more slow, and it's just gonna mess with you a little bit. Just play naturally. Once you start thinking about it, that's when you're gonna start making your mistakes. That's when your shots are gonna get a little shaky and you're gonna miss your shot. So if you really just play the game, stick to the outskirts of the map, show off, like look at those choke points, look at those objective based areas in the map where people are gonna be pushing pretty easily. That should help you guys out. And if you're just not thinking about going for those streaks, I know it sounds stupid, but trust me, there's so many times that I'm like one off a streak and then it just gets in my head and I die because I just get nervous or for whatever reason. I don't know why. But anyway, moving on to the fifth challenge here. Now, this one's gonna be called Dead Eye. This is you're gonna have to get long shots. So to get long shots here, they're always annoying. I feel like going for the long shots are always the most annoying ones to go for here because you really gotta slow your play style down. You have to just sit in the back of a map, look down a long line of sight here, and just wait for somebody to push. It gets a little boring at some time, so I'd really hate going for these ones, but if you guys are struggling getting your long shots, one map that actually really does help is actually the smallest map in the game, believe it or not, which is Das House. And if you guys just stay in the middle of the map, like lay down prone there, that is a really, really good line of sight that you're going to be able to get a lot of long shots on. It's a small map, so a lot of people will be looking down that that area anyway, and you should be able to get a decent amount of long shots per game by looking in there. But also, if you want to use a scope here, just so you can see your enemies a little easier, the scope that you guys should be rocking, is, I believe it's like the second one that you unlock for each weapon. It's called the G16 2.5. That one just helps out a lot to be able to see your enemies a little easier and just really have that long line of sight up, down unlock. But with this attachment, I wouldn't recommend actually going for them right away. And the reason why I say that is because, again, there's some really annoying challenges later on. And you're going to want to pair this off with your long shot challenges that you're going to have to do with another challenge later on in the video. We'll talk about that here in a couple more minutes. Moving on to the next challenge here. These ones are going to be called Berserker. And you're going to need to get 100 point blank kills here. Now, I remember last year, a lot of people were annoyed with the point blank kills because they were so hard to get. But I don't think point blank kills are as difficult as people have been pointing them out to be. Some tips that I can give you guys to just getting your point blank kills a lot faster. You're going to want to watch your doorways, play on some small maps. Hardcore definitely is going to help out a lot, but you're really going to want to play super aggressive and rush up into the enemy base as much as possible. So, for example, you can get into the enemy like spawn area, sit like almost in a corner or watch a doorway that you notice that they're about to push there, and then you should just be able to get your kills from that right away. Point blank kills, again, you want to just make sure that you're up in the enemy's face as much as possible. So you want to play aggressive. You don't want to play too slow here, or you're most likely going to, it's going to take you a lot longer to get those point blank kills. So we're moving on to the next camo challenge now. This is going to be called Wildcat. Now, this is going to be a little different for assault rifles and SMGs. So for the assault rifles, you just need to get 100 kills with 10 attachments here. And I mean, again, this is just another one. Just get the kills. There's no tip that I really need to give you. Throw 10 attachments on your assault rifle and just get your kills as much as possible. But moving on to the SMGs here, hip fire kills. So this is one you're going to actually want to point up. You can pair this up with your point blank kills from the Berserker challenges. So you play hardcore, you throw a laser sight on here, play aggressive and play those smaller maps. Again, look, just watch those doorways. Same thing for those Berserker challenges. You should be able to get your point blank kills and hip fire kills pretty similar and at the same time. So that's definitely something that will make things a little easier for you. But now we're gonna move on to the really annoying challenges here, and this is just something that I'm not a big fan of them. I'm not gonna lie. The last three camo challenges, for some reason, I'm not a fan of them. And the reason why is because you need to get certain kills with certain attachments, and all the attachments are different for each challenge. So you can't pair them up and go for your headshots and go for your long shots at the same time. You need to change your attachments each time that you're going for these challenges. So moving on to the seventh camo challenge you need to complete here is going to be called Survivalist. And for assault rifles, you need to get 100 ADS kills with certain attachments. I'm not going to go over every single attachment that you need to rock for. It will just state it in the main menu for each gun that you guys are going to want to change it for, because for different weapons, it is going to be a little different here. So you just got to make sure that you're paying attention to which attachments you need to rock and what challenges you need to do for them at the same time. So 100 ADS kills, just aim down your sight, get a kills with your assault rifle. But for the SMGs, you need to get 100 long shots. So this is going to pair up with your Deadeye challenges, like I was saying earlier on in the video, where you can pair these up. So you need to get long shots anyway. You need to get 100 long shots for your Deadeye challenges. Might as well pair those up here with your SMGs as well for the Survivalist and get your 100 long shots with those attachments all at the same time. So you just need to go for 100 headshots total, and then you're good with those challenges. But moving on, now we have Mind Games, which is the ninth camo challenge that you're going to have to complete here. For assault rifles, you need to get 100 headshots with certain weapons. I would love to say you can pair this up with your surgical headshot challenges, but I would assume that you probably have already completed those 100 headshots just naturally by ranking up the weapon at that point. But if you have not already, you can pair that up and get your headshots done at the same time for both the surgical and the mind games challenges here. But for SMGs, you do need to get 100 kills without taking damage with certain attachments. So the best way to not take any damage while going for these, honestly, play hardcore. Most of the time, if you take any damage in hardcore, you're going to be dead anyway. So if you're just getting kills with the these attachments. Playing in hardcore, it should only take you a couple of games to complete those 100 kills, and it shouldn't take you as long, but just like I said earlier, it's very annoying having to do that with certain attachments, making sure you're paying attention to which attachments are being equipped and what challenge you're going for at the same time. Now, moving on to the 10th and final camo challenge here is going to be called Death Artist here. Assault rifle, you need to get 100 kills while moving with certain attachments once again. And for this one, just not moving, just don't camp. It's literally like a troll type of a challenge here. Just don't camp. You just got to move around the map a little bit, get a couple kills, and you'll be good to go. Do those 100 times. And then for the SMGs, this one is annoying. Getting 100 headshots with certain attachments once again, just like I said for the assault rifles, it's annoying that you can't do these ones earlier, but you got to throw those attachments on and just get, once again, go into hardcore. Just maybe look down the line of sight, look at head glitches, stuff like that, and try to get those kills as much as possible. So those are the 10 different categories of challenges that you need to do. Hopefully this video does help you guys out. If it did, do me a really big favor, smack that like button and subscribe to the channel. If you guys are brand new, it would be really greatly appreciated. Let me know in the comments down below if there's any other tips that you guys can give some people. Let's open up the comment section to just more tips if you guys have any that could help some other people out as well. But guys, thank you all so much for watching today's video. Once again, smack those likes and subscribe to the channel if you are brand new, and I'll catch you all in the next video. Have a great rest of your day, and peace out.